guys, what's going on? Just wanted to do finally that update I've been talking about forever. This is going back to probably April, something like that, really far back there. I've been doing a lot of trading in to places like Vintage Stock, Hastings, things of that variety. So it's finally starting to add up, sort of. Some things I got from fellow YouTubers first. This is Zaranyzerak, the early days of YouTube, the 2006 one. I really like this. It's a good window into what things were like during the periods that he did a lot of this. There's one of them where I really enjoy it, and it's the video where he's showing like The Bachelor. I can't remember the name of it, but they're having to clean the kitchen. Oh, it is so funny and so gross, and it's just an awesome and just funny things that happen that don't usually get shown on things like YouTube, but I love it. And I thought it was a lot of fun. And a lot of these that you see here look better than I've ever seen them. Like if you go watch it on YouTube, this looks better than a lot of those early ones. He's redone the sound and everything. It looks amazing. If you get a chance, definitely check out Zaranyzerak's DVDs. You can go find those through his Facebook page or his YouTube channel. But yeah, he has a whole bunch of these DVDs you can get. Another one I got that I really enjoyed, I ordered this a while back when they were having a sale, and that's Into the Pit, which is a Dead Pit documentary about these two guys, which if you're familiar with Uncle Bill and Creepy Kentuckian, they've been on YouTube a long time, and they have a horror talk radio show that they do that's kind of like a podcast also. It's simulcast across a lot of different things, but here on YouTube, they do a lot of stuff related to horror genre and reviewing movies and just fun stuff. If you get a chance, definitely check out this documentary. This one I'll show. I got it quite a while back. I actually made a video of this that may or may not ever see the light of day. But I did around the town where I went searching for this, and I had a lot of trouble finding it. But this here, which is Comic-Con Episode 4 of Fans Hope, done by Morgan Spurlock, Joss Whedon, a bunch of other people, but that's the figures that I've got here. There's the Morgan Spurlock and the Joss Whedon. I think there's also one with Stan Lee, and there's also one with Harry Knowles, I believe. But if you get a chance to check this out, I really like it. I know a lot of people got to see it way before it came out, so I was really looking forward to this one. Once I finally saw it, I loved it, though. And I've got the book that goes to this also. But yeah, it's a lot of fun. This just kind of sticks to this section, and the figures are actually in there. They're just kind of little plastic figures. They're not posable or anything, but I just kind of kept it on there so you guys could see it so I wouldn't drop it. I've got a few steelbooks here I'll show real quick. These are all ones that I found randomly in places like Vintage Stock. This is the Black Freighter Watchmen DVD steelbook. So I thought this was cool. I didn't have it, so I just went ahead and picked it up. Things like this are about the cheapest steelbooks you can get DVD-wise. There was a lot of these around. A lot of people didn't hold on to them once that big edition came out that had all that stuff in it, the big Ultimate Edition. Another one I found that I thought was pretty cool is I found the Blu-ray first season of V. I've actually only seen about half this. I had it on DVD a long time ago and had to get rid of it. But I actually had been wanting to watch the rest of it, so when I saw it on Steelbook, I went ahead and picked it up. Most places like Vintage Stock will have that the same used price as they would, you know, the regular edition, not just the Steelbook. Here's another Steelbook I got. And this one is the Avengers, but this is the Best Buy pre-order exclusive, which doesn't have the movie in it. Of course, it's just an empty steelbook, but I thought it was cool if you guys wanted to see that I got it. I'll probably show it again when I actually do get my Avengers. Most of these that I'm showing now are all ones I've had quite a while. Here's Game of Thrones. I love this series. A lot of fun. I'm really looking forward to seeing the second season. I know everybody's really probably seen it. A lot of people have HBO. I haven't seen Game of Thrones season 2 yet, so I've been trying to avoid reviews and spoilers and everything, but I'm hoping that that'll come out pretty soon. To me, Game of Thrones is one of my favorite shows on TV right now that I can't see, you know, from week to week. Here's another one I got really cheap that I enjoyed a lot, and I got for like $5, and that's Unsolved Mysteries. It's called Unsolved Mysteries UFOs. This one had, and it's got a weird little slip cover. That's the way it's actually meant to be. But it's kind of just poorly designed, but and it's very dated, very 90s. I would say early 90s, late 80s, but I thought it was a lot of fun. I enjoyed it. I watched that all one day. I basically sped through every one of those four discs, and starting that morning and ending that night. So I just kind of powered through it. I've got some vintage stock finds that I'm very proud of that I've had for several months also. Here's Boxing Helena. This one here, I actually found out that it was available. When I saw it, I went to another vintage stock to get the next one. This was a really tough find. This has been out of print for quite a while. This one is $7.99. They just had it like 30 minutes. When I got there, I grabbed it. This is probably worth 20 or 30 bucks, actually. But Boxing Helena is a great movie that's been out of print for quite a while. This is the other one I found by checking that one. I went to the other store to get this one, which is Primer. I think this is a former Blockbuster rental, which I don't care. This movie's really hard to find also. Great movie. Bill Votto 79's been encouraging me to get this for a long time. One of his favorite movies. I actually had seen this already on Netflix, but I was dying to get a hold of one for probably 3 years now. So I finally found one at a decent price. And then I got Overnight, which is a pretty cool documentary. This is a documentary about the making of Boondock Saints and how crazy it is. And then the creator kind of left a bad impression with a lot of the executives he was dealing with, and he almost ruined his chance at making a great movie. So if you ever get a chance, definitely check out Overnight. I found that really cheap. Here's one that I got quite a while back also. I got this one. It was released. That's Girl with the Dragon Tattoo. This is the U.S. make, the David Fincher version. If you've seen the original Girl with the Dragon Tattoo, you obviously know everything about this already. But I like this American version. I was very surprised how much I liked it because I was expecting to not really dig an American remake because I liked the first one a lot, but I was a big David Fincher fan too, so I was kind of on the fence what I was going to think about that, but I actually really enjoyed it. I have no problems with that remake. I'm not a big fan of remakes usually, but I love that one. Then I got this quite a while back too, which is Superman vs. the Elite. This is easily one of my least favorite DC animated movies, and that's kind of unfortunate. I just don't think this was a very strong story, but I love the DC animated movie, so that's part of the problem too. I'm sure most of my feelings about this were due to my high expectations, but I love Superman stuff and I love DC animated stuff, and to me this was just, it was just a so-so story. Got this one used not too long ago, which is Beavis and Butthead Volume 4. This is a lot of fun. I'd watched this when it was on television, so I held out. I don't think this came with a slipcover. I hope not, but I wouldn't be able to find one. But if there is a slipcover for this, will you guys let me know? Leave a comment if you've seen the slipcover. This was a pretty small release on one disc. So I'm sure it's, I think they only did like 10 or 12 episodes or something like that. Not very many. I really enjoy Beavis and Butthead, so I had to get this. Here's some that I got earlier in the week, which are the buy two, get one for a dollar or something like that. And that Hastings is doing. Now I got Resurrect Dead, the Mystery of the Toy and Bee Tiles. This documentary is fabulous. Very bizarre, very strange, and it's such a great mystery. I was literally on the edge of my seat the entire time I was watching this. I knew immediately after watching this that it was a great buy. I was so happy that I got that. So that was the one I got. It's a documentary about these real tiles that have this kind of like coded weird message that's been put all over New York. But then when they find out, they've been put in other countries too and other cities. And this guy decides he's just going to figure out where they're coming from. They're like pressed into the asphalt. And it's very strange, but it's a great documentary. If you're into documentaries, here's another one I found used that I've been wanting to see for a long time, which is I Think We're Alone Now, about a guy and actually another person that are completely obsessed with the singer Tiffany, just how their life is really, it's very sad and funny, and it's just a whole lot of things, but at the same time, there's a lot about this that I felt really sorry for these people, and it's just one of those things that's kind of hard to watch, but at the same time, it's a great documentary, but this poor guy here, he's been obsessed with Tiffany basically for like 20 years or 25 years, and it's just a great movie. It's a very well-made documentary. So if you get a chance to see this, I Think We're Alone Now, cool one to watch. This one, I've only got to see a little bit of it. You guys probably have almost zero interest in this. I'd be very happy to find even two or three viewers that know anything about this, but this is the Creator Chronicles, Matt Wagner. I could not believe I found this. Whoever found this probably let it go for next to nothing. I'm a big fan of Matt Wagner because I grew up reading Grendel. This is sort of a documentary that talks about his process of making the artwork and all the things that go into his storytelling, and it's actually really long. I think it's like 3 hours, 200 minutes, yeah. But I'm very excited to have that. I've been wanting to get it, and I've never seen it other than brand new for like $29.99 or $24.99. So when you get this used for like $7, I'm just so excited. These are the ones that I got today. They're having a sale at Hastings, like I was saying before, where it's buy two, get one for a dollar. So I started buying some used horror movies. I got Intruders. Haven't seen this yet, but I've seen the, you know, the trailer for it. It looks really interesting. So with Clive Owen, I hope that's pretty good. Silent House. I've seen the original version of this that I enjoyed it. The remake I heard is good, which is kind of weird because I didn't expect that movie to be remade. And then Detention. I have seen this. I got this on Netflix. If you guys have seen Detention, definitely let me know what you think of it. To me, this is a very odd movie. And what I mean by very odd is it's hard to describe. It's a mixture of like four different genres, and it's got like a neck break pace. And the editing's quick. The story is quick. The dialogue is quick. It's very hard to describe what's likable about it, but I did enjoy it and immediately thought, I want to see that again. So I went ahead and picked it up once I saw it cheap. But, you know, those are going for like 10 to 12 bucks each, so you're really getting like three movies for like 20-something dollars, plus I'm trading in stuff. So I was happy to get that. Here's the other three I got. I got 21 Jump Street. I've been wanting to see this for a while. If you guys know if this has a slipcover, let me know. I couldn't find one. The one I got is just a regular case. I enjoyed this. I watched this earlier today, and I thought it was a lot of fun. I'm one of those guys that I like Jonah Hill. And so it doesn't bother me sometimes that he does a movie like this versus something that's more of his comedy style. But I enjoyed it because I'm a big fan of Jonah Hill. And speaking of that, I had to pick this up, especially when I saw the slipcover, and that is The Sitter. I watched this one last night, and it reminds me a lot of Adventures in Babysitting. It's almost like a rated R, like severely rated R version of that same kind of movie. It's got a very similar vibe to it. But Jonah Hill is just being Jonah Hill versus having like an Elizabeth Shue character. But it does have a similar setup. The plot's very similar. And then I finally did get Hunger Games. I was able to find one with slipcover. They had like three or four of them there used. But this was the only one I saw that had a slipcover. So I went ahead and picked it up. This is the two-disc version. And I don't know if the digital copy is still good on this. It may not be. But I thought it was a lot of fun. I watched this morning also. I've heard so much hype about this that I was kind of so-so on it. But at the same time, I'm looking forward to the sequels. I think that movie just suffers from a lot of hype. So I didn't really know what to expect. I haven't read the books or anything. Some of the movies that I got today that I'm very excited about. I got this, Halloween 4 and 5. I haven't seen these yet. But I'm definitely looking forward to seeing these at Halloween time. I know a lot of people don't like Halloween 4 and Halloween 5. I always didn't have a problem with them. I actually remember watching these at the theater when I was a kid. And I enjoyed it. And I like Danielle Harris. I was always a fan of her on Roseanne, too. After she did these movies, she did Roseanne. And I always enjoyed that. So I'm kind of looking forward to seeing that. Although I'm probably more looking forward to the Halloween 2 and 3 that's coming out from Scream Factory. And then the two TV shows I got one of these new and I got one of them used, which is Community, the third season. I love this. I watched it when it was on television, so I've seen it. I thought it was a lot of fun. I think they're really starting to hit their stride on the show, and it's unfortunate that it looks like it's probably towards the end of their show run, because as fun as this show is, as much as I like it, I don't think it's going to have enough views and it's going to have enough people to back it for it to get a lot more seasons. Maybe like this might be the last season and it's going to be a short season at that. But we'll see. I'm a big fan of Community. I think it's hilarious. This is my other favorite show that's on right now, which is Big Bang Theory. This is the fifth season on Blu-ray. I actually like that now there is a host of more regular characters. I like the character that plays Amy that was on Blossom. I can't think of that girl's name. And Bernadette, I'm glad to see Bernadette on there on a regular basis. I think it's fun to have that cast of girls that's always there, you know, opposed to just a whole bunch of guys and then Penny. I think it's a lot of fun now that the cast has kind of grown. I just don't know how much of this show's left either, now that they're in their sixth season or whatever it's going to be. I kind of have a feeling that that show is probably, actors and actress-wise, they're not going to be able to justify paying them a lot longer. This is the last movie I got, and this was recommended to me by a bunch of people. So I'm a big fan of David Cronenberg, a lot of weird stuff like that. And like the later stuff of Stanley Kubrick was one of the things that it said. But this is Beyond the Black Rainbow. It was recommended to me based on like a lot of weird stuff, and I didn't really know if I would like it, so I haven't seen it. But now that I've seen reviews coming out on it, I went ahead and took it. I didn't want to at first because, you know, I was thinking that might be a big investment, but now that I'm seeing some good reviews, I really think I'm going to enjoy that. A couple of things I've got that are from some older formats. I've got one Laserdisc, and then I've got one beta tape. This is a Laserdisc I'm very proud of. I'm a humongous fan of the movie Nightbreed. I've been wanting to get this for 20 years. This particular movie is one of my all-time favorite horror movies. I love it. It's my favorite Clive Barker movie, which is saying a lot because I really like Hellraiser and I really like Candyman. So this to me is a great movie. I'm still holding out, hoping that they're going to release the Cabal cut of this, the director's cut thing that Clive Barker kind of did that never quite saw the light of day. They're talking about restoring that possibly if Morgan Creek can find all the, you know, initial archived footage. Right now what's floating around is like VHS quality and DVD quality, but they are trying to put that together. They're raising money for it. So if you get a chance, definitely look that up on Facebook or Google it, Cabal Cut. There's a petition to get that released, and they are showing it in its kind of deteriorated form at different film festivals if you'd like to see the Cabal Cut. But yes, this is my all-time favorite Clive Barker movie, one of my favorite horror movies of all time, Nightbreed. I love it. And I got it on Laserdisc. I'm very happy. I actually got it from the same guy that I'm hoping to get some more stuff from. He had a whole bunch of movies just $3 a piece, irregardless of how much they're worth. And I got so excited about seeing Nightbreed that I just bought it without looking at the rest of his inventory. And then a couple of days later, I looked at his inventory and found a lot more movies that are really hard to find on Laserdisc, or any format for that matter. So I've got some more coming. I'll show you later. This is another one I won off eBay really cheap. This one went for like a buck or so plus shipping. But this is Black Hole on Beta. Very, very cool. I'm a big fan of Black Hole. Out of all the live-action Disney movies, this is definitely my favorite. I like this more than Tron. I don't think it's better than Tron, but it's a more nostalgic movie for me. It's one of my all-time favorites. And I've wanted it on Beta for a long time because I have the VHS version like this, this old padded Disney style clam, but I've been wanting the beta version, and I'm actually looking for another VHS copy. There was two VHS copies like this. One was a rental version and one was the retail version, and they had slightly different cover work. But this beta for just like I think it was like $2 plus like $2.65 shipping or something like that. I mean, it was less than $5, so I couldn't pass that up. But yes, that is my update. I'm sorry I kind of had to speed through this. I've been trying to get it out for a long time, and I'm trying to get this video out there as soon as possible. And unfortunately, a lot of the stuff I bought is just kind of the same stuff that everybody else has got. I think a lot of the stuff I'm showing right now, people showed like 3 months ago. So probably not showing you anything new. And then a lot of my other stuff, not much I can say on that. I don't know if there's a whole lot of interest, but if somebody's really interested in Matt Wagner, definitely check that out. I'm going to go ahead and leave you guys at that. I hope you guys enjoyed, and I will see you guys again next time. All right, take care. Bye.